How do you make requests to an HTTP endpoint in C#? Probably using the HTTP client, which would look something like this. You create the client, call the endpoint, and parse the response. But there is a more elegant way to do this, and in this video, I will show you how.
Okay, let's go.
I'm talking about the Refit library for .NET, which you can find on GitHub. Its promise is to turn your REST API into a live interface. And here in the examples, we already see how this could look like, but I would say we will try it ourselves. Let's go. I have already prepared a sample project that consists of three projects. We have a web API that uses the minimal API and provides two endpoints. A get endpoint to get a person via a specified ID. Here I'm using a repository to load the person by its ID. This person repository is fake, as you can see. It consists of these three items. You can read a person by its ID, and you can add a new person. In this case, the new person gets a new ID, and this method is called in the second endpoint, which is a post method, which adds a person, which is received from the body, and after that, it's returned to the client again with the newly generated ID. So two pretty simple endpoints. In addition, I have this library here, which consists of the person class. That way, this class can be accessed from the web API and from the third project, which is console project, which is meant to test the endpoint. And here we will use Refit in a minute. Before we start, what you need to do is install the Refit NuGet package. I have already done that. You can see that here in packages, I have the Refit package. You can simply install it either via manage NuGet packages, via the UI, or via the console as you prefer it. And now we are ready to start. And I will start with creating a new interface, which I will call iPersonAPI. Just like that. And this interface gets one method for the beginning. It's an asynchronous method. I will call it getPersonByID. And of course, I need to specify as a parameter the ID of the person I want to load. Okay, so now it's getting interesting. We have to do one thing. We have to use a attribute called the get, which comes from the Refit library, and we have to specify a path. In that case, like this. Because that way we tell Refit that we want to make a request to this URL. This looks pretty much like patterns you define in ASP.NET Core Web API. So it's important that this ID matches with this ID parameter. So what comes after creating an interface? Well, creating an implementation, right? No, not in this case, because there is already an implementation. We can see that here when you say go to implementation, there is an auto-generated implementation for our interface generated by a source generator via this attribute. So there is already an implementation and we are ready to use this interface right away. And this is what we'll do next. So I switch to the program CS of our console application. Okay, so here I will make the API call. So I need an object of this iPersonAPI interface. Let's create a variable here, PersonAPI. Yes, and in that case, of course, we do not say new something, whatever. We use a class from Refit, which is called REST service, .for iPersonAPI. Just like that. And here we specify the base URL of our endpoint, which is this in my case. And that's it. This will bring us an implementation for our iPersonAPI interface. All right, next step, we can call it. So I want to load a person via this API, so I create person variable here. And then I can use the interface iPersonAPI.getPersonByID. And I know there will be a person with ID 1, so I specify 1 here. And that's it. Super easy, right? Let's give it a try. All right, we see we indeed have an implementation, which you can see here. And when I continue executing, we have a person object, Michael Scott with the ID 1. Super easy. But how would look this with a post request? Because remember, we have this second endpoint method here, which is a post method, which adds a new person and returns the person with the new ID. So let's try that. And this actually looks pretty similar like before. I'll call this method now add new person. And here, as suggested, I specify a person object. And in that case, I need to specify the post attribute, again with the path, which is just person in that case. And what also is important now, I need to specify the body attribute for this person parameter. So we indicate that we want this person object to be sent via the request body. Now let's go back to program.cs. I create a new person here, and then I'll call await person API dot add new person, just like that. Let's try that real quick. All right, we have this person API object again. We have this new person object with an ID of -1, and then we call our endpoint, and we see we have this added person object here with an ID of 4. So the object was sent correctly to the endpoint. The endpoint did its job, sent back the person object, the new person object with a new ID, and this is what we got here. Awesome! I'm really impressed with the capabilities of this library. Of course, there is much more to say about this library. If you're interested, just have a look at the GitHub page. You will find many examples there. That's what I wanted to show you. Talking about web API calls, I also made a video where I show you how to make a HTTP request in a Blazor component. If you're interested in that, feel free to watch this video next. Thanks for watching. Bye.